First, let us show you how to open a can after shaking it.
First, we pour some beer into an earthing bottle to see what happens inside and put a balloon on the top of it to close it.
Now we use energy drinks because we don't want to waste any beer. You can see, as the pressure inside increases, the balloon expands. The carbon dioxide bubbles are stuck on the surface of the bottle.
If I would open it now, the pressure of the air above the beer would decrease and bubbles would rush to the top, pushing the beer upside and out of the bottle.
Maybe some of you would appreciate that, but instead let's knock it sometimes.
The bubbles from the surface of the bottle moves to the top, so now it's safe to open it.
Let's try it with beer cans.
We knocked the bottles a few times.
Cheers! Cheers!
With an empty bottle and a pingpong ball, you can also make some interesting experiments.
Just fill it up completely with water.
I just put the ball on the top of the water. You can see it is closed up. But
if you start to rotate the bottle, you can see it stays on top.
Cut a bottle into two.
You just need a piece of string that you put it in acetone, then roll it around the bottle 5 or 6 times.
Let's light up the string. And slowly turn it around.
Around the flaming string, the temperature of the bottle increased, and then when we put it in cold water, it suddenly dropped down.
And because of the stress, the bottle broke into two.
Now let's crush a can.
We put some water into the can and started to boiling it.
Now it's boiling for a while and the can is full with steam.
I grab it with a hand and put it inside the cold water upside down.
The steam precipitates due to the cold surface, the pressure drops inside the can, and the air pressure crushes the can. We got out this beer from the freezer, and you can see it's still not frozen. The temperature of the water is below 0 degrees Celsius, and it's an undercooling phase.
The beer is in liquid form because the lack of the presence of a seed crystal or nucleus around which a crystal structure could form.
We can start the forming of crystals with a heat on the bottle.
You can see the crystal forming is started and the beer becomes frozen. In our last experiment, we will see a very rapid color changing.
In the first glass, there's a mixture of vitamin C, iodine and water. In the second glass, there is a mixture of hydrogen peroxide, liquid snatch and water.
When we mix it, the color of it stays the same, but after a while it will change so fast. Let's see it.
We'll be back soon with